Leading Pan-African communications consultancy and press release distribution service, the APO Group, has recently signed an exclusive agreement with Getty Images, geared to change the global perspective of Africa. Nicolas Pompigné-Monyard, the founder and chairman of APO, is joining me now from Lisbon, Portugal, for more on this story. Nicolas, it's always a pleasure to have you on Channels Business Global. I'm in London, so you can't be in London and not have heard of Getty Images. We're in Paparazzi Central here in the UK. Can you just tell us how this partnership with Getty came about and how it's going to help change the global perspective of Africa?
Well, as you may know, Juliana, we signed our first partnership, making APO Group the strategic partner of Getty Images in Africa back in 2019. And since then, we are working very closely with Getty. We share a common vision. We want to use our businesses, our company, to change the perception the international media have about Africa. And we have the tool to do that by spreading good news about the continent, by spreading image which are positive for the continent. We believe that we can influence the narrative. And so basically the idea is APO as a press release distribution service, as a public relations agency, is disseminating a lot of content from corporations, African corporations and multinational corporations, which are active across the continent, international organizations. And you know, most of that content is positive because when a company is issuing a press release, it's usually to announce, you know, a new investment, the opening of a new office, a launch of a new product, etc. So it's always positive for the continent. And the agreement we made with KT is that it's quite unique. It's actually completely unique. For the very first time, not only all our clients, APO Group press release distribution client, the client willing to distribute press release with APO, will be able to have their image, the image associated with the press release, made available on Getty Image, so made available to the 1 million Getty Image subscribers, but also the press release. So the 1 million subscribers of Getty Images across the world, we're talking about 35,000 media houses, which are newsrooms, which have direct access through terminal to Getty content, will receive and have access to those image about the African continent, but also to the press release. And so the idea is that with that partnership, we believe by making available all these good news, images and text to all these media across the world, the idea is that APO Group and Getty Images are joining forces to change or influence the image of the continent, the narrative about the continent, one image and one press release at a time.
Absolutely. It's so important. I've worked in dozens of newsrooms. And if you are an African working in a Western newsroom, you're always desperate for them to use a positive image of Africa. And if it's landing in their inbox, then of course, there's no reason why they won't. I really want to talk about perception of Africa and your opinion of how Africa has been perceived during the pandemic. There were so many negative forecasts, Nicolas, at the start of the pandemic from all the international groups. Bodies were supposed to have been piling high on the streets. Billions of Africans were supposed to have died from COVID. We haven't. What do you think? How has the narrative been? From a PR perspective, how have we managed to cope?
Well, it was a reminder that if you are, for instance, WHO and you have all those you know, tips to give for the population, sometimes and most of the time, life-saving advice and tips, it's not enough to post them on your website or on your social media. You have to, and you can only rely on the media to spread the news. If those institutions were not able to rely on the thousands of media across the continent to relay the information, well, there's also information we never reach the population, right? But I think it was interesting because it reminded everyone the importance of a strong, healthy media landscape. And you can be the strongest, the most well-funded international organization with 50 staff in your PR department, et cetera, et cetera. You can have the best possible messaging and message, et cetera. If the African media are not there, the radios, the TVs, and the journalists, et cetera, to relay, to convey the information to the population, you are voiceless, in fact.
Yeah.
So I think it was an interesting reminder.
Yes. We're running out of time, Nick, but before you go, I've got to ask you how the APO group have fared during the pandemic. We know there were a lot of losers, but gosh, there were some winners. We've been discussing that on this program for several weeks. In fact, throughout the pandemic. I know you've recently done another partnership with the African Union of Broadcasting. What is the state of the comms sector? Briefly, Nick, thank you.
Well, what we've seen is it's you know, in several instances, in different industry, several people mentioned that pandemic has acted as an accelerator of the tendency was already there, a trend was somebody already there, and it's accelerated something. I think it's very much what happened in the com, if you wish, sector, in the sense that multinational companies, corporations, started to, accelerated the phenomenon, readjusting their mix, marketing versus PR. So you see less blatant advertising, so I'm the best, I have the best service, et cetera, less blatant advertising and more PR. Mm-hmm. We certainly see that in the press release distribution industry. So we saw that more and more clients are decreasing their marketing budget, advertising budget, and increasing their PR budget, and the service which is coming on top is differently press release distribution. With in 2020 at APO, we recorded an increase of more than 20% of the press release distribution business, and 30% in volume of the number of press releases distributed.
We're very fortunate, Nicholas, that you've taken out your time to speak to us from beautiful Lisbon in Portugal. Nicholas Pompinier Monyard, the founder and chairman of APO Group, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you, Gina. Thank you, Nicholas.
Sadly, that's all we have time for today, but do get in touch with your comments and suggestions. I'll see